Okay, hello guys and girls and anything in between or whichever. This is Dulayne, of course. How are you all doing today? I hope you're all well. Now, a bit of housekeeping. I've actually changed my layout a little bit. I forgot to move one thing out of the way. So, I've organised my bars a little tiny little bit. I put all my skills that I don't need over on one bar, but basically I've put all my damage skills on my normal bar at the bottom here on the left hand side. And so any damage skills will go there. Hold on, I'm going to shift that out of the way. So, because I'm using a Razer Naga and I'm using a gamepad, G13 Logitech. So everything 1 to equals or whichever, yeah, equals will be attack skills. Then I've got an alt keybind on the left, on the right hand side of my heels. And any anthems and coders I'm putting all up here. So, example control 1 is up there. If I can keep myself buffed. And of course, I'm using the wrong button. So, this is Combe. Well, now we're in Combe. So, I anticipate this will get me a couple of levels at least. And I've got some bonuses. What did I get? I got 5 turbine points and 10. Buy the riding skill. You can buy the install. I'm not going to buy it purely because it's just not. It's a waste of money for me because I'm VIP. I'll get it at 20. So I will leave that for the moment, but you can buy that in the store. First thing I'm going to do is go to the Stable Master and get my points unlocked. Always make sure you do that. It's like any other MMO.
Greetings.
Otherwise, you won't be able to stable between them, between the main points. So before I accept any other quests, I want to speak to Elizabeth Honeymead. Yeah, she's the proprietor. So, where is she? Actually, hold on, I got some money. A horse, of course. Yes. Hegstancer Farms, that's right. That's in Bree, but we're not going to do that just yet. That can wait, I'm not too fussed about that. But that's basically in Bree, but because we haven't gone the end of the quest today, I'm going to hold off on that one. So I'll show you that quest later on, but that'll basically give me the skill that I need. So let's go in here. Now do bear with me, I'm a bit out of it under the weather a bit, and I am up early, so my commentary might not be as brilliant as usual, but I'll try and keep it going. So hello, honey.
What can I do for you?
It's not often we get such respectable folk through here. My, how my tongue runs on. Tyra then told me to send you upstairs to his room as soon as you arrive. The stairs are across the room there, and Tyra then is the door on the end. So, let's go. So this is basically the prologue. In this chapter of my series, I'm going to call it chapter, because that's the first thing that came to mind. Basically, I'll be doing the book, starting book one. It will take us further in. So I will go into detail when that comes up, but this is just the prologue quest, so... What are you going to say, Tyrodan?
Greetings.
The hero of Archer, I suppose? Yeah, of course I am. I am pleased to finally meet you. I'm sorry for the cryptic summons, but I dared not betray my whereabouts to just anyone. There's much to discuss, will you hear me?
Stay a moment.
Constable Underhill, so... Yep. He's been driven from the bands of the Shire by Nazgul and Mordor. So basically what's happening is, you remember Amdir got captured. The idea now is we gotta go and try and get him out. Now the only person who can... The next person who can help us is Constable Underhill, who is a hobbit. So we're gonna go and find him. Actually, no. I wanna sell stuff. Bear with me. I'm going to get rid of all these pre-order bonuses because I can always reclaim them. Right. So thanks for all the comments, guys, by the way. I have noticed that a lot of you are enjoying the videos. I should have got the names up of the guys, but you know who you all are. Thank you all for your feedback. You know, seems like people are enjoying my content, so I'll keep on going. I am getting a good amount of subscribers at the moment. By the way, we're just going into the to get my skills, but anyway, so yeah, it does seem people are enjoying my videos, so I'm actually not sure how long I'll make the videos yet. I'm thinking between 45 and 60 minutes still, because it does take a long time to upload these. The last video was about 2.7 gigabytes. And even though I've got a fast connection, it takes like
how can I be
load,
of service?
So we will see. So, nope, no skills yet. That was a waste of time. Actually, trainers, as you notice, are the people you get the skills from. So they also sell different instruments. Loot strings. And that helps you with your healing threat. What else is it? And what level do I get? Instruments 20. So we're not going to be doing that for a while. Hey, Constable.
A lovely day, isn't it?
It's good to have the Hero of Art on our side. So, there's still a Blackwood agent in town. We think he's trying to rebuild the band from among the local ruffians and bullies. We need proof, though. A letter or parchment would do if it came from the agent himself. Many of the brigands hole up in Chetwood. Follow the road east until you come to the guardhouse. So, going up there. From there, head north and look for the brigands' watchfire scattered through the wood. So, I'll be heading up that way, but all these quests around here actually are linked to it. There's a lot of quests up in that region. Oh my god, I'm so chesty today. Tell you what, bring on July, bring on summer.
Stay a moment.
I'm sorry, my mind's miles away. I didn't see you there. Did you help fight off the brigands? My dad did. He. Gail chokes back a sob. Hold on, 1 minute, guys. Thank god I used Bandicam. I can pause the recording at any time. But anyway, during the Blackwolds raid on Archer, someone broke into our house and stole many of our things. I don't care about most of them, but they took my dad's favourite fishing pole. Now that I've moved back here to Combe, I'd be meaning to ask Constable Rainey if I could track down that pole. So, I'll go and get that back for her. Maida, what have you got?
I'm sorry to trouble you, but will you help me?
Constable Rainey. And she's just a bit worried about Constable Rainey. So we're going to go speak to that dude. Actually, are there any other quests around here? No, I forgot. One thing I didn't realise, I totally forgot about. You know, I got that free mount, the 24-hour steed. It's 24 hours real time. So, I forgot that goes. But once we get to Bree, I'm gonna stray off and get my mount sorted out. Because then I've got these mounts here, which I got for my pre-order bonuses. So, I can use those black ones.
Stay a moment.
Yeah, the Blackwolds are taking over and they've got all
might
the stuff, so we're going
to
get them
time.
Back. Click the Blackwold lockbox. The brigands fled their old encampment carrying a large lockbox. And that's another one where we're going to go and regain all the stuff that they stole after they took up Archer. They must have come into Combe and got some trouble as well.
I'm sure it will do no good, but may I speak with you?
My old dad was a robber some years back and got his hands on a good old deal of riches. As I hear it, Constable caught him, but before he was hanged, my dad told me where he buried his loot. I never needed it afore now, so I was content to let it stay buried. But I figured it's time to get my hands on wealth enough to keep you warm and shod, as my dear old called it. Can you take up this pickaxe and dig the treasure up? So, more questies. Rightio, I'm really out of practice today, what to say, so hopefully I can get it up. That didn't sound too healthy either. So where we're heading at the moment is towards that ring, and a lot of the quests are going to be up in Chetwood North, which is around here, and Combe, which is basically in this section here. So hopefully I might be able to. What, we're in 10 minutes now. I might be able to get through this in one video as well.
What can I do for you?
I didn't realise. I forgot how short Archer is. Once you get used to it, it's quite quick. I've heard many of the Blackwall brigands after looting Archer's friends Chetwood. So yeah, we're going up there. They feel that the raid might have been more successful if their followers had been less focused on filling their pockets and more on acting together. The main encampment is east down the road and deep into the northern woods. I suspect that many of the Blackwolds can be found within that camp. Yes. and she's got me connected.
How
to
can
as
I
well.
Be of service?
Looking for Coverwood, what are you? I heard sick about that boy, but I can't say his mother's going to like it. Yeah, so we're going to go and find him because he's turned into a Blackwold. So we're going to go and try and convince him that he shouldn't be in the dark side and he should be playing with the good boys. Anyway, I'm just going to head over here. Because this way is the hanging tree that he talks about. And I want to kill this bear. Why not? We need some action. I've had enough of hanging around doing nothing for ages. And of course I dinged to level 9. I want to pay any attention because I'm actually getting rest experience as well. If you don't know what rest experience is, it's a incentive for not when you logged out of the game you become rested as you do, and basically you get a bonus to XP for so long. I've actually got what? I've got 356 bonus left, so that's 356 bonus experience. I can earn. I'm going to taste down a bit. I reckon I'm echoed. Okay, so this has been cleared out already. They've already taken all the stuff from here. The so-and-sos. So, there's nothing in that stump. There's probably nothing in this stump either. Yep, it's always in the last one you search, so don't get disheartened. Ding! There may be a quicker way of doing this. I'm going to run back to Combe and hand that in real quick, that quest that I've just done, because I think he sends us back out again if I'm correct. So just bear with me a moment while I run back. Okay, and we made it back.
I'm sorry, did you need something?
I had to fix the recording, I had a bit of a problem, but I've just realised that this video is going to be 6 gig an hour, so it's going to be quite hectic. So I may have to do some kind of intelligent reductions. But there we go, this is terrible. So they chopped the hanging tree down. Yes.
Might
so we gotta find the treasure
still. Of your time.
Maybe the woodcutters at lumber camp apiece. How many woodchucks comes to my mind? So we're gonna go up to speak to Mason Fawn in the wood camp. So. Yeah, I had some problems with the recording just so it's gonna take a while to fix. I didn't realise how big these files are going to be. My ISP's not going to love me whatsoever. 6 GB files take about 5 hours or so to upload. So I'm going to be doing this very carefully. Because when you do videos, you have to really get your settings right. Because you may notice that sometimes the quality is a bit... The quality is good, I would say, but there are points where it's a bit over the top. It's a bit subpar in my mind. Because there's just so much going on at any one point. I have got a run speed buff, haven't I? Oh, Melody of Battle's a toggled skill. Okay, just realised that after about an hour. More fill me.
What do you need?
The hanging tree? Oh, I remember seeing a few. Hangings in my day. I do believe I wrote the site of the hanging tree down in my ledger. I read and all the things I want to remember, so I can just look it up in... Well, bless me. I think I dropped my ledger in the woods not far from here. Yes, I remember. We were surprised by a few blackwolves. Yeah, well, go and get your book. All these different things that people lose. Taylor Green.
What can I do for you?
Archer's woes did not escape us here in Combe. It's good what Ian is doing, no doubting that, but the evil old Blackwold has spread. So they're having trouble with Blackwolds, so we're going to go and do that, and we'll also find out there's wolves. Dead of wolves, Combe's always relied on the lumber camp, but the wolves are in there. Can you take care of them? Yeah, okay. Posco.
Could I take a moment of your
Posco's
time?
Posco's uncle. So he's lost his uncle. So we're gonna go and find him. Yeah. Now anyone else? Anyone else got the quest? Apart from you up there. I think he wants his necklace. I may be wrong, I may be right.
I'm sure it will do no good, but May I speak with you?
No, I lost my Sally's chain. So he kicked their butts, but he lost his daughter's chain, who died in the fighting. So we gotta go and get that back as well. So we got plenty of quests to do, and they all take place in here. I just love this music. I remember when I first played it back in 2008, and I was locked up at 1:00 at 5:00 in Bree. There was a sunset in the game, and there was this kind of music. It was just so enchanting, so relaxing. Not enchanting, but I felt at peace. And that's always one good thing they've done with the game. It's been, they've kept the atmosphere appropriate to the area, and they've really done a good job of it. Gotta remember to heal up every so often. Do I need to go in there? No. Don't need spiders yet. But I see a hobbit in the sights. Filbert Burrows.
What do you need?
I need, finally, someone respectable. I was beginning to think no one in the woods had any manners. I simply couldn't stand by any longer while the Blackwolds would have their way in Chetwood. I marched right in and told them just what I think of their sort. They left me right out of their camp. Go back to Hobbiton, little boy, they said to me. I've never been spoken to like this. Never. I wanted to leave. Something in that big ruin is just a bit off, I say. One ruffian, Carl Sickleleaf, he used to be a nice boy, took my handkerchief. Could you bring it back to me? He ran off to the ruins all the way to the east, between the frightening ruins to the north and the Skunkwood's farm. Oh dear. And there's a little hobbit, short and stout. He's a burglar. He's a burglar. I do look forward to the higher levels though. So much going on at any one point. Let's get in. So focused. I want to heal up first. I've got these all in different places. I gotta try and remember the different ways I've set these up. Okay, he needs a heal. I'll give him a heal. There we go. So, that's a good thing about me, I can be so helpful. So friendly. And without any thinking about it, the wolves are almost dead. Killing him with my sweet music. I gotta heal my potion. I think I did it. It's just funny how you can shout things to death and play music. Because this isn't health, it's called morale in this game. Because the whole idea of it is, if you get to zero morale, you're dead. So you're basically so sad you die. Even though we do damage to them. And when you're playing it, it's a weird concept at first. Because you're just like, well, how does that work? It's health. But it's just an interesting way they describe it. Which is pretty cool. It's different. So where are we going to go now? We're only about, what, 150 meters? Uh-oh, I see a raider. It's not a tomb raider though, is it? It's not Lara. Nah, it doesn't look like it's Lara, does it? Ow, you stunned me, you little blighter. Take my stick. So big and slow is useful, I believe. That's the good one. Yep. We're going to kill 60 first, and then 120 after. No, 30 first, then 60, sorry. So we're going to kill loads of brigands. Now, can I take this on? I've got to be really careful. Can I? Which one's got the least health? You're a signature, aren't you? No, you're a normal. Ah, I can take you. Oh, we only pulled two. That's good. That's good. I expected all three to come. So that was actually quite pleasant to know that I wasn't going to get killed straight away. Where are you going? No one said you can leave the battlefield, apart from me. Okay, so I got the Ledjar. Ledger. Running circles around ya. And that told you. Sally's chain will be up here. Right. Come on, just a bit further. That should pull him on his own. That's good. See, this content I've done so many times because I've leveled up so many different characters. I've played every class from Runekeeper. Okay, I'll go through the levels of characters I've got. I started off with a minstrel, which I did commission. That was the 35. Then I started a Loremaster. I played first at a Loremaster, and that was when Shadows of Angmar came out, which was very fun class. And I got up to level 50. I did the first raid that was in the game, which was the Balrog. Forlark. Hold on, I'm not going in there just yet. Come on. Come to me. And I enjoyed him a hell of a lot. And I'll always remember the one raid I did where there was me and another Loremaster. And basically, Loremasters are crowd control support classes. And there's one skill where you can drain power, and one skill where you can transfer power to other people. So all we do, we get low on health and we just pass power to each other, because it would cost you so much, but you'd get so much more on top back. And it made the fight so easy for the whole raid, because the raid was 12 people. So we could take ourselves from both being empty health to full health in like 2 seconds, about what, 15 seconds, which is very good. Instead of having to wait like a minute or two for your pots to cool down. And then I think after that I played, I tried loads of different classes out. I've played the Hunter, I've got to 60. My Runekeeper, which is my main actually, for a while after my Loremaster, I got to 60. He's now 65. Then I've played a Captain who's 62. I've also played a Warden twice. That was not a bad class, but it wasn't really my thing. Then I got my Burglar, who at the moment is my current main, who I got 74. So I've played quite a lot of classes, so the point I'm getting to, I've really done quite a lot of the content already so many times. And this stuff is it's all fun still, but you know, of course, once you've done it 3 or 4 times, it gets old, boring quick. But that's just because I've played the game too much. And that's why I take breaks from the game. But I really am enjoying this. I've enjoyed it since I started playing it, and I always will. And that's all there is really to it. I know Rods of Rohan comes out this fall, and they're going to be having mounted combat, which will be awesome. So just imagine your trusty steed, which can level up with you apparently, and it's going to be awesome. That's all I can really say on that. There's not much more you can say about that. So yeah, the only thing, I want to try the minstrel again because I did enjoy doing it, and I'm going to keep enjoying it. So Cole, you're going to die. I don't want to get caught in that fight just yet. I forgot what the anthem does already. Oh yeah, that gives me extra damage. That's nice. Okay. Oh dear. Okay, it's what taking about 5 minutes to complete all that first chain of quests. I'm getting some goodies. Oh my goodness, my bag's almost full. Ah, nah. Why did I do that for? And I healed, did I? Yep, Code of Vigor. I need to remember to use that in a pinch. Ping. I really could do with my mount right now. I really could. Oh, 600 meter run. No, that sucks. Alright, I'm going to cut this out. So, you all see me magically appear in a moment back at Philbert Burrows, which is just ahead, straight ahead. God, I didn't think I was going to make it back. It just takes so long to run. Oh, it's deadly, loves. Tell you what. You look like you need a heal. There you go, have some of my sweet music. Thank you very much for returning my handkerchief. I'm going to stay here and keep an eye on these troublemakers. You do that. And I'm going to go this way and hand these other quests in. Because I'm just good like that, man. Very good. God, comb's not going to take long either. I forgot about how comb is. So I think this video is only going to be short. I mean, we do go back in there again a couple of times, and I just remembered. Ah, bugger. Ha ha ha! Hold on a minute. I forgot to do these quests. Oh, darn it, I didn't think of that. Hold on a second. We're gonna go back in. Oh, darn it. There's me rushing ahead of myself. That doesn't help. Alright, okay, they run all the way back. So, we'll magically appear. We're going to go straight up here, where that champion is right at the top there. And once I get there, I will be right. You'll see me pop up on the screen again. Okay, we're in the region for Blackwolds valuables. I must have missed it at some point. Either I forgot. Let's have a look. Like I say, I should stop having energy drinks. I keep thinking I need to rely on them, which I don't. Now, who do I kill? It's the supervisor. Okay. That should only pull him. That's right. Look at how much damage I do. I was going to keep going back. I'm running to him and stab him. And there you go. We've got the receipt. Okay, so we need to go. Hold on. So one of these dudes will have it. Don't worry, you do get more skills. So damage. So you're not going to be constantly doing ballads all day. And there's the chain. Now Covel. Okay, that's not too bad. I'm not going to keep pausing it and unpausing it every so often, because that's just going to get annoying. Look where I am now. I was here. I'm here. Now I'm there. Here I am now. Yeah. Okay. Ooh, quest. Oh, that's Covel, isn't it? Yes. Come here. You need a bum kicking.
Why are you bothering me?
Okay, we're going to even the odds. You have won this round, but I will never abandon the Blackwold. Yeah, he's never going to change. Typical. Typical man. So we're going to run all the way back again? No! Right, magical gap and reappearance to commence now.
Can't you leave me to my misery?
I really hope that worked, that effect. You found my savage chain and showed those Blackwolds villains a thing or two. I don't doubt it. A lifetime of thanks, Mavaro. Ah, Sally was a good hound. I was a hound, not a girl. Okay. That teaches me for not reading it properly. We'd go hunting in the fall, and she could sniff out a coney from what seemed near a mile. It's good to have her chain back. It's all I got left of her now. Take these coins with my thanks for your trouble. Cooked carrots. Carrots. I'm going to have Vitality. Because Vitality gives health. And health, it gives resistance, I think. Never really paid much attention to that. All I know, it gives health.
Greetings.
Which you felt says you should know what that does, but that's what I know. You took care of those wolves. That'll make harvesting the trees by that den much safer, even though they respawn. Yeah, so I'm gonna have those. And I got ding number 10, undefeated. And you can do monster play. If you haven't seen some of the monster play videos, please go and check them out in the show. The show, like I say, is under the video. You'll see a little poster. If you go on there, I think it's season 5 I put them in. And you can see a couple of videos of those. You can go into the creep side level 10. But if you want to play creep side, which is this side, you're gonna have a character level 40 plus. Really, 75 is what you need. 70 plus, then you can get away with it. Free peoples, of course, is this. We're called freeps. Creeps are like orcs, trolls, orcs, all that kind of stuff. You can't play trolls as such, but yeah, you get what I mean. Also, we can get itemware, so every time you die, your armor and stuff takes a hit, and you know, every time you do damage, so eventually your items do wear out. So that's that. I also got defeated. Now I am going to try and get to level 20 without dying, because you get the undying. Yeah. So we're going to put that on. So titles is in your control character panel. If you go into C, click on title, you bring your titles up. And you can make it active. And you get loads of different ones. So, yeah. But anyway, we're going to carry on this a bit. Because that's what you trade grind, your deed grind, what for. So every time you do like a certain special deed or whatever, like exploration, so many kills.
How do you do?
You do get titles. I'm going to have power. I don't need health because I'm a healer. Oh, I'm out of breath today. It's been that time of year.
What can I do for you?
Yes.
Stay a moment.
So we're going to go back now and find it. Because it's in that field again. That's for the treasure. You know when we went to the tree stumps? And there was the thing in the tree stumps? Well, we did find them, so... God, I'm really out of breath today. But game's almost done. I know we will be going back in there at some point. Into Chetwood. Into Chetwood, because there's a certain person that we don't like, and we got to go and show him how much we don't like him. Are you connecting ties? Why are you sending me that way? I don't want to go there yet. Actually, no, I'm close now, and I. Why not? That's Constable Wren, wrong person. Okay.
Greetings.
Maya the Woodwright. So we gotta go and tell her the bad news, of course, that her son is gonna be evil for the rest of his days. I mean, come on, crime doesn't pay. Being good doesn't pay, so really, whichever way you go, good or evil, you're not gonna get anywhere, so why bother doing these silly things? You're only gonna end up dying either way. Just go in the evil route, it's probably going to get you killed quicker. And there's the stump. Yeah, someone just mentioned there the riding quest is free only for VIPs. So VIP is your subscription mechanic, so you get access to all the quests while you subscribe to the game, and you get an allowance every month for 500 turbine points, which enables you to buy stuff in the store and all that good stuff. I'm actually a lifetime VIP member because I was I'm permanently a VIP, because when the game came out they offered special subscriptions so you could get permanent access to the game, so I'm always a VIP forever, and I also own all the expansions. So I've already paid that good money for that. Now the bonus is, because I've been playing the game so long, I'm actually, anything I get now is free. So I've been playing the game for free now for the past 2 years, I think. It was $200. And I think it's $10 a month now, which is 20 months. So that's what, almost 2 years. And I've been playing the game coming up to five. No, four and
it's
a half.
A sorry day.
And yeah, so I haven't got to worry about anything. It's all the bonus. What are these? These boots were buried beneath the hanging tree. My dad was a villain to the end. Well, for them to keep you warm and shod. Shod indeed. Wait, there's something rattling around inside the heel of this one. Taking a knife from his pocket, Ted slices into the heel and gold pieces tumble out into his waiting palm. Well, I'll be. My dear old dad told me true. Wealth enough to keep you warm and shod indeed. You have my thanks, Mavaro. With this money, I'll be able to get a new start. I'll do better than my dear old dad. Oh, that's so inspirational. My dad's a criminal, and I'm going to be better than him. Oh, doesn't sound like he's going to have a hard time of doing that, is he?
Greetings.
Alright, so we want vitality. Guess I should have guessed as much. Yeah. It's locked. So we're going to go back and find out who this person is. So the strong box is that ruins. I'll show the ruins shortly.
Back greetings.
Rick. So we're going to go and speak to him.
Can I speak with you a moment?
Rick Fennel. So I got a banging headache right now. So he's going to speak to the locksmith and get that sorted out. Fate. Take fate.
Might I have a word with you?
Cutley's good intentions. Now here's an idea. Ellie's looking for new blood, so want to help her out. You could mask yourself as a ruffian to offer to join the Blackwolds. Gain her confidence and we might be able to find out where the Blackwold leaders are hiding. Of course it would be dangerous. Yes, I'm up to the task. Now I got two levels at least, so I need to go and check what I've got. I should have some new skills at level 10. Train minstrel skills.
How can I be of service?
Yes, Call of Oron. That's a nice skill. Three targets, 5 meter radius. And war speech. Now this is your... Oh, nice. So war speech is your mode where you do DPS. So you lose access to all fellowship heals and normal heals, become self only. So that's where you will rely on healing yourself via parts and stuff. Melody of battle. Right, becomes Thomas Echoes of battle. Major ballad also becomes an offensive ballad. And Coda of Vigor becomes Coda of Fury. Call of Oron. Piercing Call. Demoralizes a group of your foes and resists and then reduces their resistance to further attacks. We also get to use drums at this point. So I'm going to put that over on... No, I'm not. Where am I going to put you? Put you on... So watch, we're going into war speech now. Timeless Echoes of Battle. So we'll toggle that. No, we don't want to select it. Eh? Okay, I'm doing something wrong. Ah, it was a damage skill. Okay, so that basically... It reduces their target song and cry resist because they can resist your skills quite a lot, so that'll help on that. And it does a damage over time. That's throughout the whole fight. Oh yeah, that's the swords. Right, I remember that now. I remember that. And then, well... It's hard to describe what they do without seeing them. Because, like I say, they have changed this a bit since last time I played it. And that's not the right door! Go that way! Stupid minstrel. Minstrel being me. Oh yeah, glowy hands! Glowy hands. Glowy hands. Okay, Gale. Got your catch pole.
Greetings.
There you go. I got a trait. For completing deeds, empathy. Yeah, I'm going to put empathy on. Okay. No, you have to go to a bard for that. I'll
it's
show you the bard.
Sorry day.
I'm sorry. He did. It's not my fault. You should have protected him more. You shouldn't have let him get influenced.
Could I speak with you a moment?
Okay, friendship's renewed, yeah. The Staddle is a hobbit village in Bree. And I think relations weren't the best by the sound of it. And we're going to go and try and set them up again. Right, let's go to Rurik Fennel. He should be around the corner. Okay, we've got 20 more minutes left for this video. So Cohen will be two videos at this point.
What do you need?
One of my strong boxes recovered from a brigand. My business is keeping things locked away, so I don't often ask questions of my customers. I filled an order for 20 strong boxes upon and then. Yeah, my God, I'm talking way too fast. Sorry, guys. I filled an order for 20 strong boxes, and upon completion, was visited by the Blackwolds. One, a tough fellow, took my master key and threatened my life. Yeah, you were. Hold on. You're telling me that you got forced to do it, did you? Everyone's got a choice in what they do. Hold on, am I going the right way? I'm going the wrong way, because I'm going to go to Ellie Cutleaf now. Who is around this corner. Where are you? I'm going completely the wrong way. Right, in the interest of progressing this video, I am going to basically go up the left path, just straight up there. So once we arrive at Ellie Cutleaf's house, you will see me again. Back in a moment, guys. Okay, and we finally made it.
How can Shush I be of service?
Defeat Skunkwood's dead mother. Yep, that's our mission. We're going to go and kill a nasty wolf. That's all there is to it. Yeah, I got a nasty headache today, so that's not much of an excuse, but it's all good fun. So, instead of me babbling on because I can't think what to say, I'm just going to be quiet for a sec. Because I can. I'm not doing really much of a good job of being quiet there, am I? So what's this one? Oh yeah, I'm going to show you the bard, haven't I? Yeah. The bard is that little instrument icon there. And you can see him up there, I'll show you that now. So this is where you slot all your traits and virtues and whichever. Manage your traits. So we'll slot our empathy. Class, race, legendary. Legendary ones are what you get at level 45 onwards. You can get those. I'll show you that in greater detail at a later point. Classes will be the class related ones. And race, you have to defeat so many different mobs to get each one. And they open up at different levels. But as we get them come up, you'll see what they are and I'll explain what they do. Oh, my ears. That's what you'd be saying because I just sneezed again. Lovely.
How can I be of service?
While this doesn't help us get the box open, it does speak weather for Rurik.
Would you do something for me?
He definitely had a hard time. I mean, if you're a locksmith and someone comes like that to you and starts saying, well, you better help us otherwise, you know, we're going to kill you or whatever. You're going to do it, aren't you? You're not going to exactly tempt fate by messing about with them. Let's put my armour on. Did I get a better weapon at some point? No, I didn't. Yeah, I got my earring. Oh, yeah, I got more crap. Okay, I've got a hat. Oh, I don't want to wear that. That's a crap hat. Alright. Okay. Spare me a moment. I'm going to go and sell some nonsense in this place. Okie dokie. Onward and upward. Now the oh yes, one thing I'm going to remember to do, just so I can get back quicker, I'm going to go over here to the milestone. Wind that here. I'm actually thinking that because this is going to take another, it's going to take another little while to finish came off, and I just keep this video again to a 45 minute mark, which we're actually coming up real close to. So yeah, I will do that actually, because I've got quite a lot to do, and I'm going to take a little break between doing this anyway, so I need a break from this. I'm a bit feeling a bit icky right now, so I hope you are enjoying the video so far. So we'll be back with you to continue this on in Combe. We are heading up to the ruins in Chetwood North to continue the prologue and to finish these quests off. So I thank you guys for watching. Hope you all enjoyed. Don't forget to like the videos if you do enjoy the content. Leave me some comments and what your thoughts are so far, if there's anything you would like me to cover. And if you are new to the channel, are interested in what I do, want to see more, I am going to be keeping this going as regularly as possible. So don't forget to click the subscribe button in the bottom right hand corner. I'm coming up to 45 minutes now. So thanks guys for watching. I will see you soon. Take it easy and love you all to bits. Take care. Goodbye.